What are the mobile devices? Because you know, this topic is mainly related to mobile devices. So what are the mobile devices we are speaking about? We are mainly speaking about portable computers, tablet PC, personal digital assistants or PDA, ultra mobile PC, smartphones, computers, and Fly Fusion Pen or you know, pent-up computer, which are basically looks like a digital pens, right? So all these are basically kind of mobile devices. So next thing is that some of them are having wireless connection, some of them may not have wireless connection. So there is again, you know, different categorization and overlapping categorization as well. Okay. So if you see here, mobile wireless and handheld devices, you can see the smallest set at the core is handheld device. Handheld devices are like a smartphone. If you think about smartphone, it have the properties of personal digital assistants. Right? It is mobile, wireless device, no doubt, and it is mobile devices. Right? And again, it is definitely a handheld devices. So smartphone and PDA is another example are called handheld devices. Now, there is another kind of devices which are wireless devices, but they are not handheld devices. Okay, so which are like desktop PC with wireless access. Okay, so these are again, you can say as they are wireless, they can be treated as a mobile, mobile device, but they are not handheld device. Okay, and again, there is another bigger set called mobile devices. So there are other devices which may not have any kind of wireless connection, but these devices can be movable. Okay, like standard PDA. They are mobile devices and they are handheld devices, but it may not have wireless connection or internet connection to it. Okay. Standard laptops with wireless connection. Then laptop with wireless access. So is that here you can understand that what are the mobile devices. Now, mobility of devices and its implications. So if you see here, mobility, types of mobility and its implication. So you can see how many kind of mobility can be there. First is user mobility. That means the user is moving around. Then device mobility. That means the device can be moved around from one place to another place. Then session mobility. Okay, that means you're accessing some account from multiple devices. Then it becomes session mobility. Like in this online lecture, if you are watching this from logged in from different devices. Okay. Then this your both of the account may have a share or may share the single session. So that is kind of session mobility. Okay. Then service mobility. So mobility is there. What is the difference? User interaction model, we think of, when we speak about user mobility, then device mobility, when we think what are the, differences or things are there, like the devices must be smaller, okay, it must be battery driven, because if there is electric cable, you can't move the device. Then multiple heterogeneous network or position becomes a parameter. Session mobility, you can see issues in data distribution. So if you in many cases if you are using an online banking system, in online banking system you can't move your session from one device to another device. So it is a session mobility. solution. And there is another mobility called service mobility. Distributed life cycle management security is strong issue. Like there is a service, whether you can access the service from multiple devices. Denial of service attack, traffic analysis, eavesdropping, then spoofing, so these are the mainly, you know, major problems or issues in mobile security, wireless security, right? Now, think about device security issues. So one device, you know, can have push attack, or forced deauthentication, then mobility and disconnections are the issues. So device can face some pull attack, some device and security in networks, right? So authentication service security, it basically addresses two things: security of the device, the security of the networks. So authentication service security is required for typical attacks on mobile devices through wireless networks. So for the, you know, or you can say protection against the typical attacks, so like DOS attacks, traffic analysis, eavesdropping, man in the middle attacks, and session hijacking attacks. So all these attacks we have discussed in detail in our previous discussion. So a secure network access involves mutual authentication between the device and the base station. No, so you have a mobile device, right? How this device is going to be connected to the network? So the mobile device sends request to the base station for authenticate itself. So base station does all required computation and sends some acknowledgement message and asks for some more information to authenticate mobile device. Mobile device again send information to the base station, and base station process that, and there is the authentication process, and based on that there is a mutual authentication between the mobile device and the base station. Okay, so this happens. Okay, and sometimes you are already connected to the internet, right, with a laptop or say some tablet. Okay, and there are some web server. Okay, some is there, and you are trying to connect to the server. So that time also the mutual authentication happens between the web server and the mobile device, or with the connected device. Okay, so this happens at the time of communication. Okay, so this is to ensure the only authenticated devices can be connected to the network for obtaining the required services. These devices which are being connected are authenticated devices, and they are legitimate user to access the services. So no malicious code can be impersonate the service provider to trick the device into doing something it does not mean to. Okay. So expected services of this network. Okay. Does the network also play a crucial role in security of mobile devices? So what is spoofing? You can see here, there is a victim, or say the user, okay, one person, and this user is actually trying to connect to this server. But what is happening? His communication channel is basically, no, I who can catch this packet from my direction. Server. Again, server sends back some acknowledgement or something, okay, that goes to the attacker first, and then from attacker to attacker can monitor or can surveillance what is doing, what communication to which server. There is different type of spoofing attacks, like caller ID, website spoofing, email spoofing, IP spoofing, text message spoofing, DNS spoofing, ARP spoofing, GPS spoofing, extension spoofing, and man in the middle spoofing. So spoofing is the act of disguising a communication from an unknown source as being from a known or trusted source. That means this disguising himself like this victim. Say this is A. Okay. So the attacker is behaving like a bad actor gains access in order to execute a larger cyber attack, such as an advanced persistent threat or a man in the middle attack. Now, spoofing does or does not. So, so how to protect against spoofing attack? Turn your spam filter on. Check over the message, then hover over the URL before clicking on it, then confirm the information with the source, set up two-factor authentication, like say somebody received a mail, so that mail may be a spoofing mail for using some malware, or if there is URL, it can be using some phishing, right? So when some mails are received, first to check that whether the source is the proper source, the source, or somebody is disguising like he is the source. So no, okay. So this is something. Okay. And then download cybersecurity software. So answers for calls or emails from unrecognized senders, debugging personal information to authenticated sources. Okay, use the same password across the multiple login. Some attack to which mobile devices are subjected to are push attack, pull attack, and crash attack. So what are these attacks? Push attack on mobile devices. So the attacker creates a malicious code at the user's mobile device by hacking it, and then he or she may spread it to affect other elements of the network. So in this case, what happens? The attacker just takes control or attacks a single mobile or mobile device first, then this mobile device is used to propagate or to send the same malware or virus, malicious code to other devices in the network. So the pull attack is a type of attack where the attacker controls the device and handles it in his or her. Then pull attack. Pull attack. Yes. I can control that device and handle it in his or her way. So he can decide which email they want to receive. Okay. So in pool attack, basically, it simply takes control of a single device and, you know, control the device and, you know, even it can decide that which mail can be sent or received through that mobile device, right? So in this attack, the user can decide about the obtained data by the device itself, okay? The monitor completely out of action by causing it to either fault or run out of resources, okay? So this you will find, and many times it is something like many times you will notice that you are clicking here and there and no response is coming, okay, and your clicks are not working actually, okay. So that can be a crash attack happened on the device, okay. Not always, no, not every time it happens to us is a crash attack, but it can be one, okay. As with an overload attack, the crash attack has two phases. Okay, first, during which the attacker crashes the monitor, and so first, what the attacker does, they just freeze the monitor so that your clicks and your mouse and keyboard control will be gone. Okay, and second, during which they process with the background, they can process with some intrusion. Okay, so crash attack can be much more subtle than overload attack. So by careful source code analysis, it may be possible to find a series of packets or even just one that when received by the monitor causes to forwarding error. So the effect can be immediate and violent. Then cryptographic security for mobile devices. So cryptographically generated address like CGA is or IPv6 address. So IPv6 addresses can be generated cryptographically. Okay. So it is a 64-bit generated by hashing owner's public key address. So there is a mobile device. This mobile device is having some public key. Okay. This public key can be hashed, and you know the hash functions generates equal length. Okay, so whatever input you will give, this input length doesn't matter, okay, but the output length will be always same. Now say we said the output length is 64, okay? So it can give us IPv6 addresses are basically 64-bit address, okay. So in this way we can just generate random IP address for the mobile devices, so that attacker will not be able to identify the current device in the network. Is the corresponding private key to assert address ownership and sign messaging from the address without a public infrastructure to security infrastructure. From mobile devices. Access different websites using mobile devices, the public infrastructure is used. Okay, so for example, cryptographic provider manager in Plum OS 5 is a system-wide suite for cryptographic surveys. specifying data and resources on transport devices. Okay. Then the CPM, that means the cryptography provider manager, extend encryption services to any application written to take advantage of these compatibilities. Encryption of only selected data or of all data and resources on the devices. Then CGA based authentication can be used to protect IP layer protocol, including the NIBOR discovery, as in the context of our mobile computing applications and mobility protocols. It can also be used for internet protocol security, the handheld devices are one of the most common handheld devices used in mobile computing. Then cryptographic security controls are deployed on these devices. The next comes is LDAP security for handheld mobile devices. So LDAP is basically lightweight directory access protocol. Okay, so for desktop PCs there is directory access protocol, but for mobile devices there is LDAP, there is lightweight directory access protocol. Okay, so LDAP is a software protocol for enabling anyone to locate individuals, organizations and other resources such as their files and devices on the network. Okay, so how do we locate something on the network? You will find in the office there is network printers, there is network storage devices. So how to locate them? All these things are basically located by using this LDAP service. Okay. So on the public internet or on the organization's internet, right? So in a network, where an entity is in the network, the LDAP is a lightweight version of directory access protocol, and it does not include security features in its initial version. Okay. And smaller attacker language blended attack over RUG and ad hoc network, like 802.11 Bluetooth and infrared. Okay, on this, all these things, amount of the ad hoc network amount of code. Then in LDAP directory structure. So what structure it follows? It have a root directory. Okay. Then countries which it branches out to. Then organization, so inside organization there is a different unit, then individual units. So in each unit there will be different individuals or person. Okay. So in this way a hierarchy is maintained to locate at the leaf level things. Okay, now an LDAP server is called directory system agent. Now, security for mobile devices. Remote access service. Okay. So, for protecting the business sensitive data that deal inside mobile devices, divided into three areas: security of the RS server, security of the RS client, and security of data transmission. Understand? So there is, in the RAS architecture, there is a client, there is a server, and there is communication. So we need to secure this we need to secure this channel also, all three, okay? Then additional means like, you know, personal firewalls are available and strong authentication techniques are available, okay? Then first attackers use a domain name system, a DNS server, to locate the IP address of connected computer. Then execution of sites that are related in some sense. And second, this can post ports on these domain addresses. We can assume that the attacker came to know what is my IP address. Okay. So then they can scan my IP address, that what are the services are available on my device. Okay. So how they can do it through the transmission control protocol or TCP protocol, then user diagram protocol or UDP protocol, protocol stack to see what communication ports are unprotected by the firewall. Okay. They can check it remotely. The attacker can check it. Now, for instance, the file transfer protocol transmissions are typically assigned to port 21. So, if they find that port 21 is open and it is communicating, or that means if they are sending some query to port 21, it is replying, that means FTP service is open, okay? So, if this port is left unprotected, it can be misused by the attackers. Then protecting against port scanning requires software that can trap unauthorized incoming data packets and prevent a mobile device from revealing its existence and ID. A personal firewall or a smartphone device can be an effective protective screen against this form of attacks. Okay. For the user connecting through a direct internet or RAS connection, an RAS security for mobile devices. So this is important consideration for protecting the business sensitive data that may be reside on the employee's mobile device. It often happens. What happens is that employees in organization, they logs into their mobile devices from their mobile devices to their organizational account. Okay, so when they log in and communicates, say email ID, organizational email ID is logged in through an employee's mobile phone. Right now, after some time, the employee's mobile phone is being hacked by some attacker. Okay, and they can access all the data. So the attacker can also be able to access the company's communication or organizational communication as well. Okay, so this is a big threat. Okay. So in terms of cyber security, mobile devices are very sensitive. In addition to being vulnerable to unauthorized access on their own, mobile devices also provide a route into the systems with which they contact. They connect. Okay. They use a mobile device as a registered user, impersonating or masquerading to these systems. Okay. Cracker is then able to steal data or compromise corporate system in other ways. So another threat comes from the practice of the port scanning. Communication devices and information servers. Information server is nothing but you can think about a simple server which stores the data, okay, or information. So you can see here all these mobile devices are there. Okay, here we have the phone network. So all these devices communicate to this telephone network to some remote access server, okay? So this remote access server is most of the time belongs to the phone network. Then this remote access server allow these devices to connect with, you know, different application server. Now sometimes this communication may go through wireless application protocol gateway. Okay, so this is another thing. This device can be there or may not be there. You can see here. Okay, the communication can be directly to the application server and RAS remote access server. About the potential security attacks on the mobile devices through the music gateways. There are many examples to show how a media player can turn out to be a source of threat to the information held on the mobile devices. For example, in the year 2002, Microsoft Corporation warned about this to Windows users. According to that news, Microsoft had warned the people that a series of posts in the Windows Media Player would allow malicious hackers to hijack people's computer systems and perform a variety of actions. According to the warning from the Microsoft, in the most severe exploit of the flow, a hacker could take over the computer system and perform any task the computer's owner is allowed to do. Okay, so the attacker can have the equal privilege on the computer like the administrator have, such as opening files or accessing certain part of the network. Then networking API security for mobile application. With the advent of electronic communication, e-commerce, future offshoot to m-commerce, that means the mobile commerce, that means e-commerce when happens on the mobile, online payments are becoming common phenomenon with the payment gateways accessed remotely and possibly wirelessly. So we all do it, right? We purchase things using different e-commerce apps, and we make payments using our mobile phones. So furthermore, with the advent of web services and their use in mobile computing applications, the API becomes an important consideration. So you will many times heard about APIs. APIs allows to basically use some services which are already developed, and people don't need to develop that particular APIs helps to reduce the cost of the Now, if these APIs are provided by some unknown or insecure vendor, then it can be vulnerable. So already there are organizations announcing the development of various API software and hardware developers to write single application. Okay, so most of these developments are targeted specifically at securing the range of embedded and consumer products, including those running on different operating systems such as Linux, Symbiosis, Symbian, then Microsoft Windows CE, and Windows Mobile operating system. Okay. Then technological developments such as these provide the ability to significantly improve cybersecurity of a wide range of consumer as well as the mobile devices, providing a common software framework. APIs will become an important enabler of new and higher value services. So attacks on mobile cell phones,